गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
ओनली अदर्स जॉइन फर्स्ट, विद इन 2 मिनट्स योर क्लास विल स्टार्ट। ओके।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। Good morning everyone. Yesterday I discussed the lagging leading concept and in phase concept. Okay, so today we will first solve the rest numericals based on the lagging leading waveform. Okay, then I will discuss the waveform of the circuit where series connection is done and in place of resistor we use one capacitor. Okay, then what will be the waveform, whether it is leading or lagging, how will we understand that? Okay, so let me share the screen first. Okay. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Very good.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So basically, if we add one inductor in series with one voltage source or one current is passing, then what is the relation between the voltage developed across the inductor and what is the relationship between the voltage across inductor and current? That is basically shown here. Okay, we will also discuss this in next PPT also. So this one is another numerical. Okay, here two voltages 60 volt and 90 volt at the same frequency and with same phase difference. Okay, and between them is 60 degree. Okay, the same phase difference between them is 60 degree. So we have to find out the resultant voltage and phase angle. Now look here, no diagram is given, so you have to build one diagram. Okay, so first 60 volt and 90 volt at the same frequency and same phase difference between them is 60 degree, right? So this is your 60 volt, right? And this is your 90 volt. This is your 60 volt. This is your 90 volt. Okay. And their phase angle difference between them is 60 degree. Okay. This is your 60 degree. So when you are going to calculate the resultant voltage, you can use the parallelogram law. Okay, what was that law? That law says that the resultant vector, the magnitude of the resultant will be A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, where theta is the angle between A and B and whole root. This was the equation. Do you remember this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You can also use this formula. If you remember, you can also use this formula. Otherwise, you can use this process also that I already showed you earlier. Okay? How to get the resultant value? This is your resultant vector. Okay, this is your resultant vector. And if this vector is 90 degree, then this vector will also be 90 degree. Okay, I am marking it with double arrow for your better understanding. Okay, so this is also your 90, correct? 90 volt. And what is the angle? This angle is also 60 degree. Okay, so 90 cos 60 is your x-axis component, and 90 sin 60 is your vertical component. Okay, so vertical component is 77.9, already written 77.9, and what is the horizontal component? That is 45. Okay, so now here, if this is your 0A, this is 0B, this is 0R or OR, then OR, and this is your X extended part. So we have to take which triangle? ORX. That is already known to you. Okay, you already learned that. Okay, now, so we are skipping this calculation part. Okay, all the x-axis parts will be added. See here, 60 plus 45. And then we use the Pythagoras theorem in ORX triangle. Okay, ORX triangle, we use the Pythagoras theorem. And then calculate the angle alpha. This angle is your alpha angle. Okay, so what is alpha? That is basically the vertical component divided by the horizontal component and its tan inverse. Correct. So tan inverse of vertical component divided by horizontal component. So that is 36.59 degree. Now, this writing is very important with respect to horizontal. Okay, because if you do not draw this diagram, then this angle is between which vectors? How will you notify? How will you let the teacher know that this angle is between whether B vector and R vector or R vector and A vector? So that's why here it is written with respect to horizontal. That means with respect, this angle is between OR and O A vector. Okay, clear? Okay, fine. So this is over. Now, next one. Okay, now here we are going to discuss the circuit and phasor diagram for resistance. Next, when inductor is connected, when capacitor is connected, then RL circuit, RC circuit, and then some numerical based on this. Okay, so first, when only resistor is there, right? So here, look, only resistor is connected, and what is the equation of voltage developed across the resistor? That is purely based on Ohm's law, correct? So I can write that VR equals to I into R, correct? So if I, see here, IT value is given as Im into sine omega t plus theta, correct? Now here theta is assumed as the existence of the phase difference. Suppose there is one phase difference in IT, correct? Suppose this theta is your 10 degree. Okay, for your understanding, I am writing in place of theta 10 degree, correct? So when you multiply this IT with R, then you will see that VR, this VR value, its phase difference is also same as the before, that is also 10 degree. Okay, that is also 10 degree. So what is the phase difference between the voltage across the resistor and current? That is basically zero. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you multiply the current waveform with the resistor, then you will get the voltage across the resistor and the all the waveforms. All these two waveforms are in phase. Correct. Here, look, if this theta is 0 degree, here the waveforms are drawn based on theta equals to 0 degree. Okay. If this theta equals to 10 degree, then your waveform will be different like this. Okay. This waveform will look like this. If this is your voltage waveform, okay, this will be your current waveform. Okay. Okay, just a minute.
Hello.
Yes. Just wait 1 minute. Wait 1 minute. I am having a one call. Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes. Fine. So, the waveform between the voltage and current in case of the resistance, is it clear? Okay, when we connect one voltage source across one resistance, the voltage across the resistor and the current passing through the resistor must be in phase. Okay, next, this is the relationship. Okay, because this I is equals to Im by root 2, that is the maximum value. Okay, this is the RMS relationship, right? In case of the AC current and AC voltage, this value is denoting the RMS value, Im by root 2 and R into Im by root 2. Okay, is there any problem?
So how root 2 is there?
Yes.
Root 2, how?
See, when, okay. How it comes? Did you remember the RMS value of the AC sinusoidal wave? What was the RMS value you had calculated? That is A maximum value divided by root 2, right? So here also, if you want to calculate the RMS value of the current, RMS value of the voltage, then that will be I maximum value divided by root 2. And similarly for voltage, R into Im divided by root 2. And since there is no phase difference between them, so if this angle is theta, this angle is also theta. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, this is the phase relationship. They are in phase. That's why this is written like this. Okay, theta V equals to theta I. Or you can generally denote it like theta. Okay, no issue there. Now, next one is the inductor with sinusoidal supply. Now, you already know that this inductor, when is connected across the voltage source, if it is DC source, then in ideal case, that inductor will act like a short-circuited path, right? But in case of AC supply, that is not happening, because in case of AC supply, the waveform changes 50 times in a second. That's why it is called 50 hertz frequency. Okay, now the main thing is what we know already, the unit of the inductor is in Henry, right? Henry. But we cannot apply Henry in our original equation. We need to convert that Henry into ohm. Okay, how will we convert that? That is done by multiplying the omega. Okay, what is omega? Omega is the angular frequency, that is equals to 2 pi f. Okay, what is f? F is your frequency, that is 50 hertz.
Correct.
Now, this 50 hertz frequency and this 2 pi when multiplied, that means it will give you simply 100 pi. Okay, if you multiply, what is the value of pi? If we take only 2 decibel, that value will give you 3.14 approx. Okay, so 100 pi value will give you 3.14. Okay, so when you see one waveform written like this, suppose A T equals to 100 sine 3.14 T, then you can clearly understand that this waveform's frequency is 50 hertz. Okay, remember this one, right? Because this 3.14 equals to 2 pi f, and if you divide it by 2 pi, you will get the 50 hertz, right? Now, when omega is multiplied with this L, it will convert it into ohm, okay? And it is called the inductive reactance, correct? This is called the inductive reactance, because if all the values, all these values are not converted into ohm, you cannot use that in equation, right? So this is called the inductive reactance, that is XL equals to omega into L. Similarly, if we connect one capacitor instead of one inductor, C, okay, C is the capacitance value and its unit is farad, correct? F-A-R-A-D. Also, you cannot use that while calculating the resistance or impedance, right? So you have to convert this into ohmic value, okay? And this conversion, after conversion, we write this as XC. It is called the capacitive reactance, okay? When inductor is inductor, this L is converted into XL, it is called inductive reactance. When C is converted to XC, that is called capacitive reactance. Okay, so now first we need to complete the inductor voltage, right? So VL equals to L into di dt. I value is already known to you, okay? Now I value is Im sin omega t, correct? This I T equals to Im sin omega t. Okay, see here, Since IT equals to Im sin omega t, that means there is no phase difference. Okay, so it will start from the reference 0,0 point. Correct. So it starts from the 0,0 point. As you can see, this violet waveform. Okay. It denotes the current that is passing through the inductor. Clear. Next, we developed the equation of the voltage across the inductor. So VL equals to LdI dt. So in place of IT, I wrote down Im sin omega t. Okay, now you can differentiate easily. So omega L Im into d dt of sin omega t, it will give you cos omega t. Correct. Now, what is this omega L? That is your XL, that is the inductive reactance. Okay, so inductive reactance is then multiplied with the current. Correct. Now, this value, this XL value is called the inductive reactance. Now, here one mistake is there. This will be 90 degree. Okay, not this is 900. That is 90 degree. Okay, because sine omega t plus 90, that is also cos omega t. Correct. So, this value, if you take the magnitude only, then VL magnitude value will be XL into IM. Okay, clear? Is the calculation clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, okay, now look the waveform. In that waveform, see the VLT according to our equation. See this equation. Okay, see this equation. VLT is a function of cos omega t. This equation is of cosine waveform, right? So this cosine waveform is drawn here. You can see the cosine waveform, because cos 90 is always zero. See, this point is giving you the zero value. Okay, now this cosine waveform, we need to convert it into sine, correct? So if I convert this into sinusoidal waveform, then we need to extend it. Okay, we need to extend it. Okay, so we need to extend it. Now you can see that this voltage waveform, in case of the voltage waveform, in case of the inductor, leads the current waveform by 90 degree. Is that clear?
Yes,
is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, any query? Any query till now?
No, sir.
Okay, no, sir. Very good. Next. Next. This is the phasor diagram. Okay. If current is your reference, then voltage will be in leading condition in case of inductor. Okay, now we can also conversely say that if voltage waveform is your reference, okay, in case of inductor, if voltage waveform is your reference, then the current will lag by 90 degree. Can I say this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, because if you rotate this phasor, okay, if you rotate this phasor, the same waveform you will get. Okay, always remember, always try to remember that if you connect one inductor now in one circuit, then that circuit will always the voltage across the inductor will always lead with respect to the current. Correct. Clear. Now next we connect one capacitor. Here see, the capacitor unit is in farad. I hope it is clear. But you cannot use this capacitor. So you have to convert this capacitor, okay, into the ohmic value. Now how will you connect? How will you convert? The conversion is XC equals to 1 by omega C. Okay, that's how we are doing it. Now, how we are getting this equation? Let's see this. How we are getting this? Okay, here look, the voltage waveform suppose is our basic waveform, our reference waveform, this voltage, the blue colored waveform. Okay, now what is the equation that we already know? That is I equals to C into dv dt. Do you remember this equation?
Yes, sir.
Then in place of v, write down this vm sin omega t. Okay, now if you write, then you will see that I equals to C into d dt of Vm sine omega t. Okay, now Vm is constant, so I can write as C into Vm. Now after this differentiation, what you can say? That d dt of sine omega t is omega into cos omega t. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Yes, sir. Then I can write this as omega c into Vm into cos omega t. Correct? Okay. Now, if I want to write in the form of Ohm's law, how can we write it? We can write it like I equals to Vm cos omega t divided some reactance value. Okay, that is suppose XC. So if I take the magnitude, if I take the magnitude, I can write this as I into XC. So Ohm's law is satisfied. Look, okay, I am taking only magnitude here. Okay, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then what is the value of A? Okay, is it from which part? This portion?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, so up to this omega c Vm cos omega t, this calculation is okay. Correct. So now, suppose we need to convert this equation, we need to convert this equation into some magnitude form. Okay, so I am writing it in magnitude form. So mod I, we can write this as omega c Vm. Correct. This one is okay.
Yes, sir.
I am considering only magnitude, because cos omega t means it will give you the waveform, the phase difference. Correct. So
yes,
if I only consider the magnitude, so I can write it like this. Now what is this omega c? If I want to write in the form of the Ohm's law, because Ohm's, what is the, how the voltage is developed? The voltage equals to current into some resistive property of the element. Correct.
Yes.
That is the main equation. So here, in case of, what is the resistive property? the resistive property is your XC, that is your I into XC equals to VM. Okay, so I can write it like VM divided by XC. So what is the value of XC if you equate this equation and this equation? The XC value is 1 by omega C. That's how we are getting the value, the conversion equation. Now is it clear?
So X equal to 1 by omega C.
Yes. Because see, this one is omega C. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So from here and from here, I can write omega C equals to 1 by XC.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So omega C is 1 by XC equals to 1 by omega C. I can say that.
Yes, sir. And then XC equal to 1 by omega C. Yes.
Clear, Hua?
Yes, sir.
Now, is this conversion clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
this conversion
sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. Now, next, we are going to calculate the phase difference. This is basically the magnitude part that I already discussed till now. Okay. Now we are going to check the phase difference. What is the relation between the voltage across the capacitor and the current? Okay, now look, the voltage is already, I had written like Vm sine omega t. So it will start from 0, 0. Is it clear? It will start from 0, 0. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Next, what is the value of I? The I value is omega C into Vm. Okay. So omega C into Vm, this portion I am writing as Im because that is basically the maximum current that will pass through the capacitor. Correct? So this is Im cos omega t, correct? I can write it like this, Im cos omega t, correct? So basically this cos omega t, you need to convert it into sine. Okay, so if you convert that into sine, you will see that this value will be Im sine omega t plus 90 degree. Okay, so I am writing here Im sine omega t plus 90 degrees. So which one is leading, which one is lagging? Please tell me this.
So current is leading, sir.
Current is leading. Very good. So current is leading by how much angle?
So 90 degrees.
Correct. So when you connect, so okay, first draw this. Okay, since the current value is less with respect to voltage, so magnitude will only be less. Okay, so dotted line is the current. Dotted line denotes the current waveform, and the voltage waveform is this conform line V. Okay. Now, so total three elements we can connect in the circuit. Okay. If we connect one resistor, voltage and current are in phase. They will be in phase. Okay. If you add the inductor, then the voltage will always lead the current. Correct? Voltage will always lead the current. And if you connect one capacitor, then I can say that voltage will lag the current or I can say current will lead the voltage. It depends on the circuit. Leads the voltage. Are these three cases clear to you?
Yes, sir.
To everyone, it is clear now, because based on this concept, your RLC series circuit calculation will be done that you already experimented in lab. Okay, in virtual lab, obviously. Okay, so now in step by step, we will see what is happening. Suppose here I am connecting one resistance and one inductance in series. Okay, here's look, one resistor and one inductor are connected in series and voltage is here. Okay, so what is our resultant voltage and what is the phase difference between the voltage and current that we need to calculate, right? So since they are connected in series, try to understand first. Okay, calculation will be done later. Try to understand first. When current is flowing, the current will be same for both the cases, correct? Because they are in series. Okay, now what is the phasor diagram for this resistor and current? The phasor diagram for resistor and current means they are in phase, I, and VR, they will be in phase. So I am drawing here. This is your I. Okay, this is your I. Okay, this is capital I. Now, so capital I is written here. So make it capital I. Okay, it will help you to understand. So here capital I is there. Okay, and here I am writing VR. This one is clear, I think. Yes? Okay. Next, the current is flowing through the inductor. So VL will be leading or lagging? Please tell me.
Leading, sir.
Leading, sir.
Very good. Why lagging? VL is always leading. Because look here.
Yes, sir.
Correct. Because in case of capacitor, V will lag only. Because see here, here the current is leading in case of capacitor. So voltage will always be lagging with respect to current. Correct? So here the current is your reference and voltage VL will always be in leading by 90 degree. Okay, this is your 90 degree angle. So now calculate the resultant. So what is your resultant? Use the Pythagoras theorem here. Okay, this is your resultant. Okay, so what is this voltage? What is the resultant voltage? Resultant voltage is this. This V is your total source voltage, okay? And this is your total voltage. Okay, so what I can say that V equals to root under of VR square plus VL square. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Now, can you calculate this angle theta? What is the value of theta? Tell me.
The tan inverse VL by VR.
Exactly, tan inverse VL by VR. Basically, if you take the cosine of this angle, if you calculate the cosine of this angle, that is called the power factor. Okay, that is called the power factor. Okay, this cosine of this angle, what is power factor? Power factor is the cosine of the angle that is between the voltage and current. Okay, now this is for the resistance and inductance, where resistor and inductor is connected. Okay, now look at the equations. Okay, now what is this one? V equals to V square equals to VR square plus VL square. Okay, that is okay. Now from here, in place of VR, I can write I into R. Okay, in place of VL, I can write I into XL. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So now take I as common. So if you take I as common, I can write it like V divided by root under of R square plus XL square. Yes? This is the total resistive property of this circuit. This is called impedance. Okay, this is called the impedance, that is denoted by Z. Okay, so total four terms you just learned. Okay, first one is XL, this is inductive reactance. Okay, next is XC, that is capacitive reactance. Next is Z, that is the called the impedance. Okay, so total three terms, and last one is the power factor. You learned the power factor. Okay, what is power factor? That is the cos theta. In the manual, in RLC series circuit lab experiment manual, you will see that it is told to find out this cos theta value. So that is basically the power factor of the circuit of your lab experiment. Right. So this is the impedance. Now, what is the value of this angle theta that is already developed, that is already calculated by you? Okay, I wrote that as theta, so you can write this as theta or phi. Okay, so this theta is the tan inverse VL by VR. Okay, now what is VL? That is I into XL. And what is VR? I into R. So I and I will cancel out. So I can write this one as tan inverse XL by R. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So we can draw from this phasor diagram. Like this. This is the voltage triangle. Okay, it is called the voltage triangle. It is also the phasor diagram, and it is also called the voltage triangle. Okay, so I can also say that theta is the angle between the Z and R. I can say that this is your Z, this is your R, and this is your XL. I can say that because if we multiply in all the sides, it will give you the phasor, this phasor diagram. It will be converted into this diagram. Okay, so this triangle where only Z, X and R are present, this is called the impedance triangle. Okay, it is called the impedance triangle. Okay, till now I hope clear. No confusion is here now?
No, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so today's class is up to this. Okay, in next class, we will learn this series resistance capacitance circuit, right? So all of you give your attendance in the chat box, and all the study materials will be uploaded in Google Classroom within today. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.